I'm Dr. Senjuti Saha. I'm a scientist at the Child Health Research Foundation located here in Dhaka, Bangladesh. I focus on meningitis because it is a severe form of disease and it can lead to death and disability of many, many children. As a microbiologist, seeing so many children come into the hospital with meningitis, sepsis, and fever, and not knowing what caused the disease can be very frustrating. Our foundation has 5 labs across Bangladesh. One of them is in Dhaka Shishu Hospital, where we conduct surveillance and collect patient samples for genetic analysis.
So this is our lab, and here are Raleigh and Shajib loading a sample into our sequencer from a case of meningitis. Here is the rest of the lab processing different samples from different cases of infectious diseases. And here is Dr. Shumir, with whom I share 50% of my genes.
That's correct.
My father is a microbiologist, so I also wanted to be a microbiologist. My father is my mentor in life and in the lab. When he started in this hospital in 1983, all he had was a broken table and a stool in the corridor of the hospital. There was no microbiology department then. Today, we are a group of over 250 people working together towards understanding what causes diseases, what are the diseases in Bangladesh, and how can we treat and prevent infectious diseases and improve children's lives. Through a collaboration with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative, and Chan Zuckerberg BioHub, along with the Child Health Research Foundation, we set out to understand what are the root causes of meningitis in Bangladesh and perhaps beyond. Children under the age of 5 are the most vulnerable to infectious diseases. The cause can be bacteria, a virus, fungi, or even a parasite. It is difficult to tell. And when you know the cause, you have a chance at saving children's lives. When we suspect that a child has meningitis, we perform a spinal tap or lumbar puncture.
In that process, we draw a little bit of the fluid inside our spinal cord called the cerebrospinal fluid, or the CSF, and we can test that using metagenomics.
There are billions of microbes living in our bodies, and not all of them are bad for us. To figure out what microbe is causing the disease is almost like finding a needle in a haystack. Only in this case, the haystack is as tall as a skyscraper.
Having a sequencer right here inside the lab has been extremely important for us. This means we can process samples and sequence them right away. We load the sample in our sequencer, but the sample contains both human and microbial data. We upload the sequencing data into Chan Zuckerberg ID software, and Chan Zuckerberg ID does the rest. It decodes the info, removes all the human data, and compares the remaining information to databases of all known pathogens, flagging the pathogen present in the sample, ultimately leading us to that needle in the haystack. Chan Zuckerberg ID allows for communication with labs all over the world. I can be sitting here in Bangladesh, but working with colleagues in Nepal or Brazil in real time. It allows for global collaboration. This collaboration has allowed us to go back into our freezer and take out samples from cases of meningitis. Using metagenomics and with the help of Chan Zuckerberg ID, we were able to solve 50% of these mysterious cases.
There is so much to be grateful for in this world. Overall, global health trends are positive. However, there is still so much more to do. I believe everyone should have equal access to the practice and benefits of science. Science by and for the many, not the few.